The two swiftly leaving drivers pilot their machines to the top end of the racetrack, and it's Antoine Brown. 372.5 by 0.8 of a second. It's a whole shot. Everybody's green here. In fact, Caps was off first by a little. Caps' car, the outside of the groove. It's forced by 0.8 of a second. Double 09. Anderson's not bad with a 30. KB versus Elite, the piston pumping engines. It will be Enders. Auto hole shot, 653.6 beats a brutal 651.5. And Angie might have just made one. She gave Steve Johnson 200s. The Denso onboard camera looks down the drag strip. It is Johnson on a hole shot. A 200s hole shot. It translated directly. 610,000s at the stripe. Camry Caruso dials up an 0-11 reaction time on Greg Anderson. He's trying to make up the gap, and at the finish line, it's Camry Caruso on a hole shot. 6607, 208 miles an hour.
Taylor's bike sounded like it bogged a little bit, but the 60-foot number wasn't that far off. That's pretty good drag race down at the finish line. And how about a 697? Beats a 692. Ryan Ehler wins it by less than 1/1000th of a second.
A great side-by-side drag race, and the win light goes for Langdon by 5/10000ths of a second.
Hornow had a 007 reaction time. Has he got enough motorcycle? Oh no, by 0.5 thou. 695, Mark Ingerson. You're also taking the tire off the ground as far as contact path. Reaction time, 0.02 of a second. How about this? 1/10000ths of a second. Eddie Krawick wins it.
Erica is better by 0.61ths of a second. At the 8th mile, Coughlin still leading at 1,000 feet. It's a draw, it's Coughlin! By 1/10000ths of a second. What an amazing race.